Well, Kianni Torres comes from a modern and far-flung family. She has dozens of half-siblings all around the world.
Hi, my name is Kianni, and I am a donor-conceived child. And as of today, I've found over 65 half-siblings. Here are some of them.
My name is Emma, and I live in Tampa, Florida.
What's up, guys? My name is Maggie Fuchs, and I'm from Macon, Georgia.
My name is Meredith, and I live in Macon, Georgia.
My name is Alana, and I live in Tampa, Florida.
Hey, I'm Espy, and I live in Northampton, Massachusetts.
My name is Zach, and I live in Columbus, Ohio.
There you go. Yeah, Kianni, she's on a mission now to meet as many of her half-siblings as possible, including some right here in Australia, and she joins us now from Florida. Kianni, such a pleasure to speak to you. This is an amazing story, it really is. Your dad is donor number 2757. When did you meet him, and what was that like?
I met him when I turned 18. That was because they had me wait until I was 18 to meet him. And when I did meet him, it was actually really overwhelming, not only for me, but for him as well, because he technically forgot that he even donated at one point. So I kind of just popped up and was like, yeah, hi, you have, you know, this many kids out there in the world and we want to meet you. So it was super cool to actually meet him. It was really overwhelming, but really fun and a quirky fun day.
What was he like? Kianni, what was he like?
So he was actually really smart, really funny. He came up with some like really sly jokes every now and then. When I did go to meet him, I wasn't sure if I was going to hug him or shake his hand or maybe not touch him at all. And he was very welcoming, he opened up his arms to me and gave me a hug. So it was very sweet in a way. And he answered any questions that I have. So he was a very open book, open-minded person.
You knew from the age of four that you had been donor conceived, and you had to wait until you were 18 to officially meet your biological father. But in the meantime, you started contacting your donor half-siblings by using a register on the sperm bank. What was it like? I mean, meeting your donor sibling, your brothers and your sisters, that must have been the strangest experience.
It's actually really, really fun. It's almost like an instant connection at first. So when I first met my siblings, the first time I met one, it was actually two twin girls and they were about 3 years old. So they didn't really understand how I was their sister, but they just knew I was their sister. So they clung to my hips and they were always constantly wanting to hold my hand and be around me. And that just kind of sparked my interest of being a big sister. And I just wanted to meet the rest of them and enjoy that that family bond that doesn't really necessarily fit the normal mold.
Yeah. Yeah, but you've since discovered you have more than 60 half-siblings around the world, and you've met a lot of them. You just mentioned about the connection you had there. Do any of these half-siblings not want contact, or have any of them met each other?
Yes. There are a few of them that we have found, like, let's say, through DNA testing. Maybe they were in search of who their father was and they found us, but then weren't too excited to find siblings. So they politely requested us not to contact them. But otherwise, the rest of them that I've found so far, I think I've met 27 of my 64.
Wow.
They have been super excited to meet us, and they love going on all these adventures. So we've been having really fun times.
You also have half-siblings right here in Australia.
I do. There's four of them over there.
Wow. Can you tell us about them?
I know that they're, it's two different families. And there's one family with one son and one family with three kids. Two of them are twins. And they're all a little bit younger, so they have met each other, but they haven't met anyone else yet. So I'm kind of waiting for them to get a little bit older for me to actually travel over there and go meet them.
Well, what does it mean to you to meet your half-siblings? I mean, is it kind of filling some missing pieces or something within your life?
I see them as an extended family wherever I go. They're family that I just haven't gotten to meet yet, and I just want to build that relationship with them.
Oh, great. I think it's beautiful. I really think it is. And Kianni, it's such a fascinating story. Thank you for sharing yours with us.
Thank you so much for having me.